I need that practice. I want this W. I know I can do this too. Let's go again. Nice part is this first boss, I feel like we got it down now. I think that those three orbs, those three blights, are very paired next to each other. I don't think that you have to turn around. I think that they made it controller friendly, if that makes sense. Because controller players have to, you know, turning around is way harder on a controller than it is on a mouse keyboard, that's for sure, right? So I don't think that they would make the blights behind you, if that makes sense. What's the consensus on the new legendary sidearm? Very good at anti-barrier. Literally one-shots the barriers. That's the only use I've seen from it, though, so far. I wonder if that machine gun's any good. Threat roll. So we've got one, two, and three. Yeah, so they kind of keep them all in the same line of sight. I definitely want solar resist on in this one. Phase, which is fine. I kind of wish I had a solar hand cannon that had shoots loot on it. Yeah, no. One, two, and then three. Yeah, they all have to be in the same area. So for some reason in my mind, I thought that they could be like behind you, like Bungie's like has like some crazy aim trainer type stuff. Like that's just stupid of me. It's just actually pretty stupid of me. Is only at times one. I'll have my super for the next one, which will help. Like, Bungie is not gonna have you do an actual aim trainer and have to freaking 180 whip around and shoot the blight, you know? They're all three. Whenever you find one of the blights, the other two will be nearby. I'll have to make a updated solo guide, make it easier for people even, potentially. I feel like you learn these little things as you've invested more time into the activity. So I found one blight. Okay, so the other two are gonna be nearby. Hold on. A little bit off to the right on that one. A little bit off to the right. Not too bad though, like not a 180 behind me. We'll see though, maybe I'm wrong. doing, my guy? Deceased. The three phase. Easy. Was there a day one emblem for this? No, that's for raids. There's no day one dungeon emblem. That would be a cool idea, though. So I have to make four of them go clockwise. So apparently the indicator for this is that this guy makes you go clockwise. I don't know what, like, his arm, his left arm is on there. And then this guy's, his left arm is there. I don't know about that one. For whatever reason, the first one you spawn into, that's the number of clockwise ones that you need. I just can't tell. There's something about the way that the skeleton is oriented. His left hand goes that way, so that's counterclockwise. And then his right hand goes this way, so that's clockwise. Because clockwise is to the right, and counterclockwise is to the left. That's actually pretty crazy, though. I actually give kudos to Bungie for that one, for making something that's actually a perplexing puzzle. In fact, I should make that into a video. Maybe I'll do it on the next one. You just guess the mechanic completely? Yeah. It's not necessarily clockwise or counterclockwise, it's just you have to make them spin to the left or spin to the right. Also, whoever it says anti-clockwise, if you say anti-clockwise, I don't know what happened to you. There's no hope for you, though. I almost just got frozen and fell into the pit. That would have been actually hilarious. I have not tried the season slug yet. That would have been so very funny if I got frozen. Light.gg rates threat detector above demo on the Swordbreaker. Is demo better for Strand Titan? Demo is much better. And yeah. It's interesting when talking about topics like that, because you never want to be like, you never want to insult someone's opinion. There's definitely a good argument to make for threat detector, don't get me wrong. But demo just instantly reloads the weapon and gives you grenade energy. And so it's like, they're not necessarily that far apart, but demo is the better option in my opinion. That insta reload from throwing your grenade, that's huge. Lightshot.gg, they have good ideas. Don't get me wrong, they have good ideas. Sometimes there's stuff, the problem is that when you apply a simple solution to a complex problem, you end up with you skip over a lot of nuance, right? So you try to, oh shit, hey yo. When when you try to apply a simple solution to a very complex problem, it just doesn't quite feel right. But that's okay. I think they do an okay job, you know. But yeah, demo is definitely the best option in my opinion. It's going to auto-reload your gun in its entirety. Plus, you're going to use your grapple anyways because you get a free grapple melee. So it's like, you know. It's a weird thing, though, when you talk about god rolls. There's a lot of opinions and there's a lot of, no, you don't know what you're talking about. And it's like, all right. People be going crazy when we talk about god roll stuff. It's also getting more difficult to talk about god roll stuff because it's hard to gauge, you know, who to listen to and who's the real experts and stuff like that. I try to get my information from a variety of sources that are like, you know, spreadsheets of damage testing, stuff like that, versus like, you know, other sources. It may not necessarily be as in-depth, I would call them. There's a lot of sources. Here's the problem, is there's a lot of sources for Destiny information now. Sifting through what's the best and what's the worst can be difficult at times. So I think there's a lot of people that just like to just say their opinion of things and say, this is the god rule, this is the best thing, and maybe they haven't quite done all the testing necessary to have such a strong opinion, you know. It'd be kind of like if I gave you medical advice. I am not a doctor. Like, all right, Lucky said to, you know, he said to take this medicine, dies. It's like, well, the problem is there's no Destiny College, right? There's no, like, you go here for Destiny College, and then you become an expert in how to, in god rolls and builds and stuff. There's just people that make content and do well. And so then they become the expert, like, de facto or whatever that's called, right? An expert by proxy. But there's a lot of people fighting to be an expert in Destiny, that's for sure. I say fighting, like competing to be an expert in Destiny. I swear, I open up my TikTok, I open up Twitter, I open up YouTube, any app, and I've got, this is the new god roll, this is the best build. From everyone. Everyone and their grandmother giving me god roll guides these days. Mobilytics recommends slide shot with 1-2 punch. I mean, it's not bad. You know, that's not the interesting part about talking about god rolls, is that when you have perks that are comparably good, you know, it's not necessarily bad to use slide shot. It's not like wrong. Not like if you use slide shot, you've made a horrible mistake, you're an absolute failure, you'll never be able to solo any activity. You know, it's like you could just use slide shot, sure. That's where everyone's got a different opinion, it seems like. But that kind of just shows how, like, a lot of the perks in, like, the left-hand column, at least for the Swordbreaker, there's a lot of good perks there. Oh, shit. I need to go here. I'm gonna make this. I'm gonna get my Banner of War proc'd a little bit higher. Here now. Give it some time though. Well, fighting cool times 5. Yeah. This guy is too far away, man. Why are you so far away? No, I activated it too early. I need that freaking. Why is this over here? Alright, we're gonna use the super on the last one here. Just gonna get in here. Part that's interesting about that though, like for the Swordbreaker, to jump back into that, is that so everyone's in the left-hand column, you're kind of just focused on a reload perk, so there is some subjectivity there where you could be like, this reload perk I think is better. Because like, I'm telling you it's demo, light.gg is telling you it's threat detector, Mobalytics is telling you it's slide shot. They're like, which one do I choose? You know, well then, if it's a little bit subjective like that, then you can just kind of pick which one. If you feel like you slide around a lot, use slide shot. If you feel like you know how to use your, you know, grenade in that combination, oh, I think I did that too soon, then just do that, you know? If you feel like threat detector is going to be the best because you're going to be surrounded by enemies, because technically you will be, then use that, you know? Like, it's... They're not wrong for using threat detector or slide shot on the Swordbreaker. You do technically want, like, a reload perk on it. I've used the melee perk on it. Like, for example, I used Pugilist on it for a little bit, because I could get my melees back a little bit faster. Most people would say that's the wrong perk to use on it, though. So... good office. But I think those conversations are fun, as long as, you know, we try to respect people's difference of opinion. You know, you don't want to say that someone's, you know, opinion is null and void or something. But there's just a lot of good perks in that calm. People gotta think for themselves. Yeah, a little bit. You gotta think for yourself a little bit. You can lean on the expert's advice for god rolls and builds and stuff, but you definitely gotta think about it a little bit for yourself too. Like, what's your play style, you know? Like, for example, if you're the type of person that never slides around, then definitely not slide shot for you, you know? But if you feel like you slide around all the time, you know, then definitely use that. There's also a certain playstyle that goes with certain god rolls and builds a lot of the time. You know, are you playing aggressively? Are you playing solo? Are you playing with the team? Do you like to sit in the back? Do you like to play distance? This might get me killed. I'm nervous here. Oh, you fucker. Please don't do that. God, that had me. That's the worst feeling you can get, is when you're nervous that you're gonna die and then you melee whiffs. You're like, well, It's nice knowing you. It's nice knowing you. I believe I activated both of them. I only needed one though, so it's not gonna matter too much. Alright, now we're down to our last thing. We're gonna do that, we're gonna do one of those, we're gonna do that, come over here. Bank this. Get my Banner of War proc'd again. Oh, I had to pop my super now because that Banner of War was not proc'd. Banner of War should have been proc'd, I felt like. This. Alright, we're gonna get it done in 5 phases, it looks like. It would be way more optimal and efficient if I used like the grapple point. I just don't know how to do that yet, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've seen these grapple point berserkers. Super impressive what they can do. I really want to learn that. It's like a... it's a skill that's super difficult, though. You have to, like... actually, maybe it's not that difficult. You probably just create a grapple point... create the tangle. You just grapple to it a bunch. It's probably not bad at all. I'm probably just being a weenie and not learning it like I should. Yeah, they always do, they use Navigator, right? And then they create the Tangle Point. Which is good. I understand that. Problem is, then you don't have your debuff of your tractor. So I'm not sure if that's... I'm not sure how much that matters, but... I might try that pretty soon here, though. So I'm feeling like, feeling like that might be the play. I saw someone one phase this guy. And I'm like, I'm about to do 5 phases, and you're telling me it's possible to one phase? I'm doing something wrong. You get the boss with three phases and Warlock? Yeah. I'm gonna have to use that. I'm gonna have to use that grapple point pretty soon. I've been putting off learning it because I watched someone do it and I was like, that looks crazy. That looks really complex and difficult. And then you like, you're like, oh. Like, oh, actually, I basically have to learn how to do that if I'm gonna use Strand Titan. Hey, fire the thing. This. Do that. Pop this, you can survive already. Go over here. Slide into here. Boss is nowhere near me, classic. Should have made a tangle, I felt like. Hey, you pushed me into it. You son of a bitch. Oh, melee whiffed. Love that. Let's just get out of here so we don't die. Yeah, I seriously need to learn that grapple technique. This is just getting ridiculous. Been putting that off for too long. Bust out the old navigator. To throw it into? Where the ads at? Activated. Look like they're both activated, which is good. pretty much don't go down there without having woven mail. Was like a mistake to go down there without woven mail. I pretty much leave all these scorn alive just because they're free targets to hit with the tangle. Server's saying they're unavailable, you probably just have to do an update. Our internet's bugged out. So, Binnacle times 5? Interesting. Almost through there a little bit. I saw that. I was like, surely Biting Cold is gone. Should have meleeed those guys, so. Make sure I wake up here. Banner of War proc. Gotta get out of here. Tangle literally just disappeared. We love that. Off a little more than I could chew there. Thankfully, I survived. When there's no ads around, things get dicey. Things get very dicey. Might be able to get it done in one more damage phase if it's clean. No Fortnite event? For me? I haven't played Fortnite in forever. I haven't played Fortnite in forever. Oh my god, die, please. Oh, well, that's gonna be awkward. We're gonna do one of these. We're gonna come back here, we're gonna grab one of these. We're gonna stand in here for 2 seconds, and we're gonna get out of there. No. I don't think I got it in time. That sucks. That's just funny, though. Hey, 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 hey. It in. Good. Kind of hard to stand in the two of these. Getting really bad RNG with these spawns. Don't talk about that. Don't talk about that. Don't talk about that, chat. I'm going to start talking a lot less now, so I need to focus up. I need one so I can kill this guy sooner than usual. Let's go. Hey, this is a solo flawless run, yes. I have not died in this run. Yet. I should say yet. So I just gotta make it to the boss room. I'm trying to remember where the spikes were because I'm paranoid now. I don't think there were any more spikes, right? I think there were no more. Should I grab one of these chests? Should I? This one. Just kidding, I'm not that dumb. Come on. Can you imagine? Imagine if someone in their run, they actually do randomly grab the chest. They're that crazy. Don't be greedy. I think the best way to solo floss anything is just be chill about it. Like, this has been the most chill run, the most relaxed run I've had. Just, like, reading chat, chilling, vibing. And I haven't died. In the other runs, I was, like, hyper-focused. I was like, oh, gotta be optimal, gotta do this, gotta do that. And then died. It's like, yeah. Yep. Seems about right. Seems about right. Oh shit, yo. Oh shit. I'm out of here. Never come back here again. I'm out. The save, exactly. The freaking save. Get me out of here. I don't want to fight these guys for no reason. Can you track on to something, melee, please? Hey, what the? Boss, what the boss doing? Go away, you're toxic. Huh? Yeah, I'm about to be at the final boss here when this is Soul Flawless too, so. Just gotta make sure I play it nice and chill. Pay attention to my restoration. Really, that's the only thing that I think that gets me killed is just not reproccing my restoration. The rest of it is pretty easy. Let's do this. We gotta go here. And we're putting on this build right here. An overlap. It's gonna be trouble. Best start. It's okay. I think I killed the wizard on that side then. Thank you. keep running out of my restoration. Where's my restoration? I threw my healing aid at my feet and I shot adds. Makes no sense that I would have no restoration there. Makes zero sense that I'd have. I think I just need to get my super back. I don't know if I'll make it to the end if I don't. I'm just gonna do another wave to get my super back, I feel like. I don't know. I threw my nade at my feet and shot Scions. No restoration extension, huh? I'm very confused as to how that happened. I was being super meticulous about it too. Very confused as to what the fuggity fuck just happened to me. Throw the nade. Shoot the scions. Put the wall down. Blind the guy. Okay. Punch the guy. Run away. Restoration timer is very low. Restoration timer is back to maximum. Restoration timer is out. Gotta be mindful of that. I think I pushed to the next area though. So I think we're good with that. Be acceptable. This part here. Yeah, back at the beginning. A wizard over there. No, no wizard over here. Fucking die, Scions. Oh my god, Scions just don't die. Just never die. Just keep multiplying. Die. 10 million Scions. 10 million Scions. Fuckers. Of course I missed the hammer, dude. I'm so salty, man. I just had to hit that hammer. That's all I had to do. Hey. One eternity later. Holy. Do have restoration momentarily. Got ammo. I would like to get my super back. Halfway to my secret. Just lost my restoration. That sucks. Just lost the restoration. Oops. Oh, save that. Make sure I stay alive on anything. Restoration. Got no need. I'm trying to get my need back. There we go, we got the grenade. We're gonna kill this wizard. Game started here. The wizard is gone. Shoot that. Why did I throw a healing nade at my feet and I don't have restoration? Must have not shot an ad. Afterwards, I thought I did shoot an ad though. Very weird. Desperate need for ammo now. Hopefully have a scavenger on. I think I might have double surges on. That might be part of my problem. Yeah, I do. Find a place to, if I can pause and fix that. Without dying. Nervous. Solar scavenger, please. Thank you. Hey, what the hell was that? We're not about to fall off the map, are we? Come on. Restoration. You son of a bitch. Damage from back here then.
No.
Had no restoration. Keep running out of. I didn't have my Titan wall when I needed my Titan wall, and then I used my nade when I wasn't supposed to use my nade, and I didn't have restoration when I needed it. My goodness. Trapped here forever, I swear. I keep using my nade and I just run out. I think I have the build on where I don't have. I have the build on where I don't have on, not Imperium, but Solas. I actually quite like Solas. That guy's getting launched. Not sure though. I feel like I should have it on. I'm just running out way too much. Times 12. Yeah, I should have it on. It keeps getting, or 12 seconds rather. I'm just getting in my own head. Let's just focus up here. Nothing to shoot. There's literally nothing to shoot. So I'm left throwing my nade. It's okay, I guess I have the nade for a reason. How's that tracking onto me? What is going on? My brain is falling out of my fucking skull, I swear. Right, let's get it together here. Alright, breathe. I just threw my nade and I didn't get an ad kill, so, man, I think I don't have restoration right now, I can't tell. I don't have restoration. It's rough out here, chat. My last brain cell was used. My last brain cell was used up. On something else, apparently. Trying to get my nade back. Throw your nade, kill a scion. Nade, scion. Nade, scion. Nade. Scion. Either kill Scion. There's no Scion here to kill. Oof, get it at my feet. Watch this guy. There's no special ammo anywhere. So we're just left shooting with this. That one. I need special ammo. How did I melt through all my special? That's weird. Fucking more power ammo. Need Scion. Where's the dang special at? There it is. A brick. There we go. Not much better. Ran out of restoration. Okay. Gotta get restoration back with the baby hammer this time. Go, so pick up that ammo. Alright, we got this. They messing around here. No way. No way. I did it. I actually did it. Man, I started off today trying to wager high stakes and say, you know, if I solo flawless, if I die, I give away an emblem. I spawned in and died in the first 2 minutes both times. I was feeling down. I was feeling like such garbage, yo. You know what I'm saying? To go from that to successfully doing it only two tries afterwards feels pretty good. It feels very good. It wasn't a clean run by any means. We definitely had to do double damages on those waves, but we stayed alive and we successfully solo flawless the new dungeon. Let's go. That's what's up.